Creek, and we're chasing a few bass and bream on the surface. Cicadas are out about in force, so we're just throwing around some little cicada type lures. This one's a little tiny cicada by Tiemco. They do the soft shells, but this is a little hard one. It's a nice small little one. It's great on like bream and bass. The hooks on it are a little bit smaller, so your bream can get their mouth on it and that. So, got a pretty cool little action too. So, here we go. Fishing cicadas to me, like I try to match them as best as I can. When you're fishing these little cicada patterns, like your siglet, your megabass siglets, and these little TM codes and stuff like that, a lot of guys just flick it out and just slow roll it in, and that works. But I tend to like flick it in there. You got to get it tight into the structure. That's like a big thing with any sort of bass fishing, especially snags. You got to get it tight into the structure, and I tend to try and just get them to vibrate, because if you ever seen a cicada sitting on the water, they just sort of vibrate. They don't actually, they can't really move, so they're just sort of on the spot and vibrating and drift around. So if you can get that happening with your little cicada lure as well, and all you do basically to me is just rattle the rod tip a little bit, and it'll sit in there and sort of vibrate, and it'll slowly work its way out, because to me the longer you can leave that lure deep into that cover, it's going to work a lot better. The fish are either going to hit it out of hunger or just get agitated and smack it, because it's annoying the crap out of them, really. Not yet. Yep. Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. He's deep in the snag now.
He's laughing now.
Come on, you. Ah! Bugger! I knew that was going to happen. He was deep in there.